So.
And what's your battery saying?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you see it going low, you have to end the light so it saves it, yeah?
Okay. Yeah. So, yeah.
Nice.
You're on live now.
Yeah? What's good, people?
Hold on. There are more followers that you join. Okay.
Alright, people joining?
Not yet.
Give it a hot second, maybe we get one. What's good, people? I'm Shintastic, representing Two Real Boys. You know the vibe. I'm gonna try this again and teach you guys some Litefeet. I bought different stuff to what I tried to do before that you didn't see, but some of the same stuff, so it's still all the good stuff to get you started into Litefeet. But I bought some other like interesting things to experiment with and play with. Y'all are sick already. We're probably already good. I'll hold this for a second. We'll hear it. So yeah, first we'll start the drill, get really warm, get into it. And then I've got like a combo that we're gonna go through and it's gonna kind of break down Litefeet and how to use it and stuff. So let's go. Keep that going. Double tap, and let's go. Ready? Triple tap. Hey, and let's go. Whoa, this door's gonna close on your phone. Another one. Cool? So, we got it slow. Hey, hey, hey. Double time, let's go. Oh, oh. Good tempo through the music. Here's my arms moving at good tempo through the music. None of this is foundation right now. It's just a drill. We'll do it one more time and then we're gonna get into this work. We're gonna get into this work. Switch on the vibe. Stretching, I'll just get straight to it. Longer class, I'll be stretching, but you're getting straight to it. I'm gonna go over teaching two different steps, then I'm gonna go into the combo. Me going over and breaking down these two steps is gonna make things a lot easier. Oh, y'all. Keep using my songs, man. We good. Alright, so first step we're gonna do is the LB. Tried to teach this before, we're gonna try again. But we'll do it slightly different when I bring it in the combo. I'm gonna change it up. LB, you're just hopping out on one leg, other side, four. Chest out. Arm up like a Statue of Liberty. Hey, yeah, and that's the LB. Cool. You can start changing that, making it after you get used to that movement. Simple. Cool. And then after we get used to that for a bit, I want to go into what we call the rev up. Let's do LB for a bit. Yeah. Back to the back. To rev up in light feet. We like to get ourselves charged up already. It's just a small series of steps that when you learn them, you can start making it your own kind of thing. Yeah? It's good space.
Yeah.
First step.
In Ajana's work, we don't use.
Yeah. First step, we're going to start on my right. There's no right or wrong for this, but we're going to start on our right for now. So you learn rev up both ways. It's like breaking, you learn six step both ways. Cool? So right leg, you're gonna step one, and I'm gonna turn my hips. One. Yeah? So I can turn my waist and turn my body that way. Boom. But what I don't want you to do is go right back. Yeah? We're not gonna do that yet. I want you to really get this waist rotation because it's important and useful next time, yeah? So we're just gonna go one. Notice my knees are bent. One. Arms, just swinging this way right now, yeah? Arms are quite free for the whole of this move. Whatever you want to do when you get some knowledge or if you want to tuck or whatever, it is what it is. So go in. One, and you bring yourself together, keep yourself grounded there, yeah? One, and. Yeah? One, and. One, and. One, and. You bring yourself down. Yeah, cool. Then we're going to step back. Two. Cool. And with that, you're going to lean your weight back as well. So go in. One and two. Yeah. Let's go to there. Six, seven, and one. Two. Get this step here. You see this leg? That's kind of, I like to turn it. Boom. And get that. As soon as that lands, that's when my waist turns. So I'm not trying to turn my waist beforehand. I'm trying to get. So they feel, yeah. Cool. So,
behind.
One, two. From there, what we're gonna do is go three, and you're hopping, kicking sideways, perfect. Hopping, kicking sideways, three, and four, and you just bring that down. When we bring this down, again, bring your hip into that, boom, four. So you're getting that. So you'll be on that accent of the beat. Two, four, six, eight. So watch me.
One, two, three, four.
Yeah?
One, two, three, four.
Yeah. Go again. One, two, three, four. Cool. What I want you to do is try to hold your center a bit when you're doing this step. So, if I was to not hold my center and just let the steps take me where I need to go, I'll be using all of this space. Right now, I want you to kind of hold the center, but let your legs still do what they need to do. So, back here. Notice I'm keeping it, tightening it in, bringing it in, just to get that sense of control. So, here. Cool, what we'll do it just slowly, and I want you to watch my arms. What's helping with the illusion is that my arms usually go opposite to my leg. So when I go this way, my arms go this way. One, and two, so I'll go back. When I kick this way, my arms go this way. Three, and four. And my arms go that way again to bring that in. Cool, one thing that's gonna this step is the right leg in between it. There's two ways of doing it. You can go one and two, and have that board. What's keeping me fluid is the one and two and three and four. Did you see this leg here again? One and two and, so I'm getting that, put my weight back on this leg, so then just pop. Yeah, and get that in there. So, just one more time slow.
I turn, one and two, three and four.
Watch the and,
one and two and three and.
Getting you charged up in the beat, ready before you do something
crazy.
You know what I mean? Like, so, river, so important. There's not one way to do this move. When you understand the logistics, the, all right, I'm just going backwards and forward, do some spanky footwork, you're gonna start changing it.
Ooh.
Still taking those first steps of the rev up and maybe putting something else in it. Boom. Cool. So rev up. Do this second one if you're finding this first one hard. So here, one and two. We could do kind of like we did with the LB. Just hop out then back in. And again. We here. Two. When you finish, whether you finish here or here, get ready to start back on the and to redo the rep. So when I'm here, one, two, straight away my leg, and it's coming up here, and three, two, three, four. Cool. Again, the arms are a bit free. LB, LB, rev up, rev up. Done. Ha, 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 ha. Hey. Oh, that's one rev up. Two LBs, one rev up. And two LBs, one rev up. We repeat, we repeat, we repeat. Watch me. Basketball games, you'd have someone called AJ Voice of Harlan. He'll be like, get the light feet going, get the light, or he'll be spraying on the mic, not rapping bars, but being an MC, old school MC proper. He'll be talking about the dancers while they're dancing, making them go off. And this used to just happen on the court in between a basketball game. Bill went to parties, house parties, and then the battle era came out. They were running events. Because life is that bad on the street, as well as in these events. And then the style just starts to advance and go on and go on and go on. Till we're here today. I can't remember where I was going off to. Okay, so, there's so much, and you can't squeeze it all in one lesson. So much. We just did LB party move, kind of gets everybody in the room like, hey, when you see someone do this, you're like, something like that, kind of, but it's not quite a trend. Party move, boom, boom, boom. Boom, rev up, is getting you charged, getting you ready in the beat. Yeah, up to the next. Now we're ready to drop some kind of killer combo, some kind of move, or say a sentence or a statement, whether it's about ourselves or something we've made in Litefeet, to then lock in. Lock in being the boom, or the boom. Yeah? That's kind of like the full stop exclamation point at the end of this sentence or statement that we finish making, kind of thing. So we did LB.
LB. Never.
I want to put in one combo here where we're going to just slide back. Round, round, right, left, and then go for a clap. This move's called the Jono clap. It's just another party move in Litefeet. You would have seen it trending all over TikTok and people doing it. But yeah, it's just called the Jono clap. But I'm doing it like in my own kind of way. So we're gonna slide back. Right, left, but don't do the clap. It's like your hands are gonna bounce off each other. And then you're gonna lock in there. So it's kind of achy. Go here. Boom. You can go here. Or here. Best one to start with is just putting your hands behind your head and then bringing them down to center. When I'm doing this lock in here, kind of looks like a star jump, like this. But no, it's a star jump, you go up. We're going to be going down. Yeah? So it's like a, what are they called, jumping jacks? I don't know, I can't remember. Yeah? So, step, arms behind the head, and straight in the center. Yeah? Bring your weight down.
Oh, yeah.
Too heavy. Bring your weight down. The door closer than that. Yeah? Yeah, so boom. Let's just go through LB. LB. Rev up. Ooh. We're gonna rev up again. No, we're not. We're just gonna do one rev up. So rev up. Push back. One, two, three, four, and five, six, eight. Cool. So that'll be our kind of little move statement before we lock in. That's me just grabbing the Jono clap, changing it a bit to make a different version of a jump clap. Which you should do with all these moves.
Shall we?
Ooh. With these rev ups, your arms can always change. You might see me sometimes, I do this naturally, sorry. But you see this step here? I might naturally just go and change it to that. My arms do swing that way. Or I may just click, or clap, or however. It's kind of free with the arms. Again, these are just, they're not like, you have to do it this way. These are just moves to kind of guide you and build your right feet, if you know what I mean. Let me try something. This is called slag in, slag out.
Slag in, slag out.
So you're going to slag out. Jono clap. Swing, swing. Right, left. So you just move the shoulders. Ha. Really sell that you're going for that clap. Ah. Boom, yeah? You gotta set it. Changing the music so you get a good sense of all the different types of songs. Ready? 6, 7, let's go. Now we're gonna go in. I'm gonna start.
Drink some water.
Drink some water. Everything we've done there, use to warm yourself up and always get yourself ready for light feet. Now first drill, and then go like here, and then like that. Those things are gonna get like some of the foundation movement of light feet just in your body. Ready to do at any speed, fast or slow. Yeah? That drill plus what we've just done, training something simple as the LB, training the rib up, but change it, think of how you're gonna change that. And even this combo here, hey, hey, ta ta, boom. You have to find what else can you put there that's gonna fill the exact same gap, yeah? Whether you do slide back the same, but you do something else like a, or you do a, hey, you know what I mean? Anything, if you fit in there, tap, tap, boom. You remember the lock-in, that's the end of your sentence. What you say before that is all you, kind of thing. But let's go. What we're gonna do, alright, what we're going to do is we're going to start with something we're going to put just before the LBs, okay? Likely you'll see them always do some kind of big entrance or something to say, boom, like, I'm in the space, now I'm going to start dancing. So what we're going to do is, I'll count you in, 1, 2, 3, 4, we're going to go, and you're just going to tap your leg. Next, so you can step back. You can go. And 5, so my foot comes back. You could drop your foot like this and have your heel up, which might make it easier. Or you could drop your foot like this on an ankle break if you want. I'll have my heel up for now. So I've gone and 5 and 6. So I've made a circle now between there. And this is what you call a thread. It's in breaking and all sorts of stuff. Light feet, we do a lot of threads. Most famous is the jumping front with the legs. That's what we're known for on light feet. So we're going, and 5 and 6. When you land this leg, that's when you're gonna turn and you're gonna turn sharp. And 7, then knock in, and 8. Now we're gonna stop. Kill. So we're gonna go again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, and 7. Cool. When we finish it, 8. First move we're gonna do is the LB. I'm gonna annoy you guys now because now we're doing it on this side first. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3. Cool. Let's go from the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, and 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. LBs. I'm gonna go just to the next part and then we'll put that on music. Go to end the song. Back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6, 7. LB. LB. Stop here. Will you stop here? And back. So it's just a kick. Cool. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yeah? And 5. What we're going to do here is called an ankle break or ankles. In light feet, we break our ankles. You'll see turfers and stuff do it, but we do them in slightly different ways. But we're just going to go on our inner ankle on this leg and come back really quickly. Basic, but gets you a good start into it kind of thing without you breaking on the ankle straight away. Here. So, LBs. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6. So it's and 6. I haven't got my weight on my leg when I do this, by the way. I'm not going out, 6. I'm going away from it. And 6. Yeah? So, and 6, and 7, and 8. So I'm just here. So it's knee, foot side, and 7, and 8. And we'll go to there. So just from the top. Back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6, and 7, and 8. Cool. Music.
Music. For the music.
Yeah? Ready? 1 all of that, and you still are just getting started. You still just revved up, get ready. All right. Okay, one more time. This time, feel that energy. Feel that buildup. Yeah, really feel the energy. This wrap up, really get your energy behind that, get your body behind that. But I'm not breaking my body off, I'm not doing this. This is starting to wrap up, holding my center, holding my core so you can feel it. Starts to understand the logistics of it, and you'll start doing moves naturally, if you know what I mean. But it needs to be drilled. I'd spend, when I first started, it was Yuji that told me I was trying to learn a bunch of advanced Litefeet moves, and all I had to do for my drill was just rev up and lock in, rev up and lock in, and that cleaned the whole of my Litefeet. All these fancy moves that I was practicing before, I could fit them in better because my foundation, where my rev up is, my locking is always sharp, always clean, always on that beat, always in that pocket. So it's from standing there, putting on a whole Litefeet playlist, whether it's 20 minutes long, 40 minutes long, an hour long, you'll be like, come on. Just keep that rev up going. Yeah? How can you change it? Hey. How can you change it? How can you? You make it yours. Hey, hey, ooh, hey, hey. Yeah? How can you repeat it? And then time your lock-ins. Yeah. Hey. Ooh. And then back, straight back into that rev up. How many songs can you do that for without being like bare tired or without the quality of your movement deteriorating? You know what I mean? Like, eventually your body will get tired. So I'm drumming like this, I'm not drumming like this. Yeah? Same thing happens with all your movement. So those drills help us stay clean and consistent. Get it!
Come on.
This is crazy, it's crazy. I've been working,
maybe easy for you. When I first went rev up, really not hard, but it was a learning curve, one of these. You know, you gotta rub your belly, you tap your head, or vice versa. It's just one of them steps. And I always had to get used to it. And that and step. Stay in it. Yeah, that was just one learning curve I had to pass. Some of you guys, you may get it straight. I've told people before and they've got it quicker than me. But it's like, how? What are you now gonna do with all these things, with all these tools? Are you gonna go and go off, do your research, go watch some battlers, learn names and stuff? Are you gonna just keep it to yourself? Maybe just not, you might not be feeling like feet, may wanna do another style or something like that. But it's like, what are you now gonna do with this information? How are you gonna build from it? How are you gonna create from it? And that's what's so important about the locking, because everyone can do a locking, everyone can boom and bring people in, boom. But it's what transpires before the locking is what's gonna build the energy to bring everyone in. You gotta do something crazy or something really spanky and stylish, you know what I mean? Be spanky, spanky and Litefeet is just like how lockers and poppers call the funk. Yeah, and they got the funk, yeah? Spanky is Litefeet's funk kind of thing, yeah? Is what we say. Or we say stupid, get stupid on it, and that's just get stupid. Well, you think stupid, innit? Because it's all really just like to have fun with the dance, if you know what I mean. So, this next part, whoa, when we finish, do the LBs, do the LBs, do this, like, tap, tap, slap that, woo, tap, tap, boom, start getting our river, get charged in that beat. We're gonna do this step. This ain't like an official Litefeet step. This is just a little something that I've grabbed a couple bits and pieces of moves and put it together. So it's like a Shintastic original step. You're gonna go cross, open, slide, cross, open, slide. But you're just gonna jump to each side. So I'll go jump, open, slide. Oh, no, I jump again on the slide. So I'll go jump, open, slide, jump, open, slide. So your feet are doing like this. It's a gangster. Hey. Oh. Yeah? Yeah. Boom, 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 boom. Step here, it's gonna seem really fast, but it's not that fast. We're gonna do like a part of a ray or a ball change, but we're gonna hop on our right first. You're gonna hop. And just step open up and open it up. So a hop here, boom, change. Step. It's gonna be left. So it's like right, left, right, left.
Like a pas de bourrée, similar.
Yeah, pas de bourrée. It's just that first step is you're hopping off this leg to land on it. Yeah? So we're gonna go boom, 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 boom. Cool. But that's after the two jumps and the hooks. If I do it from backwards, so you can see. Forward. Sideways. Backwards again. Yeah? So you can actually see the footwork. First step, through here. Boom, boom, clap, boom, boom, clap, boom, boom, clap. Fast. Yeah? Watch me again.
Boom, boom, fly, boom, boom, fly.
Are you here? You're going to imagine, I don't know, you're probably in singing in the rain or something like that, but you're going to kick your leg forward and just let the other leg slide with it. So watch, I'm like, you kick, and then kick back. So we're going, and just bring yourself forward and back. After this, really sharp kick. If you're on concrete, it's peak. If you're on carpet, it's peak. You better have some socks on, y'all. Sit, seven from that step. Let's go from here. Sit, seven, boom, 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 boom. To the boom, back, it is fast, no? It is fast.
have to reload this beat because this is one of the Litefeet bangers.
We go from the top. Remember, we start there. Slide,
slide,
bring it back forward, tap, tap, and with here you just need to drop your hand, straighten your leg, boom, boom, and then bring it here. You have time to bring it there, plenty of time, but then the challenge for this move, I'll do it sideways, when you're here, you're going to just jump and tap your foot. I did teach sit tight toes last week. You didn't get that lesson. So I didn't want to brilliant again this week. This is called tic-tac-toes. When you're tapping different joints to other joints, and we do it in Litefeet called tic-tac-toes. This tic-tac-toe is hard because you're here and you're going to tap this foot but land back on this foot. So you go, boom, yeah, and you land. That was in time. Yeah. Cool. It doesn't have to be a high jump, it's about the flick of the foot. Flick of the flick of the foot. Yeah? Even if I do it really low and don't jump high. Yeah? Obviously it looks good when it's up here. You get me? Alright, cool. So just breaking that down slow. Let's go from here. 5, 6,
slow. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah? You have tap, tap, tap. You can clap and then go for the hop. But it's tap, tap, tap. You've got prep time. I can count there to get yourself stable. Boom. After you land, boom, boom. Straight away, go for that lock in. So I'm here. Yeah? When I go for that lock in, I'm trying to generate my power from the ground and going down. I'm not trying to get up here. I've just come from up here. It was weird, innit? I have to generate that power from the ground. Yeah, and go down after I get that. Cool. So, without no music, just for a second, and catch my breath.
You have some water?
No music, slow. 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, that's still a lot. 8. Rev up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No! You know, your mind just goes boom.
Oh, is it not?
Yeah, boom! Yeah, so this step, yeah, so you just throw it up. Thank you.
Pop that tap.
Pop, pop, pop.
Boom,
yeah. Really expand out, go down as far as you can, because that's the TKO. Alright? Oh! No, I might add something else, but we'll see what's going on. We'll see what goes on, we'll see if it fits. It is the spirit. So why not? Play something.
Hey yo, Wiz!
Christmas!
Let's go.
One, two, three. Up, 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 up.
Christmas track. I got the Christmas
back. Hopefully it's starting to like make a bit of sense. The combo will get easier and easier, but I brought the combo so you can understand how to make your own Litefeet combos, if you know what I mean. I've given you the framework, the rev up, the lock-in, then there's these party dances. If you need to know more dances in Litefeet, if you want to look more at tic-tac-toe, or you want to see more ankle breaks, or you want to see more threads, or you want to see some tricks, could we do tricks as well? That's for you to go and find your research, yeah? I've been in this country where there was only a handful of us doing Litefeet, and we had to find each other and go on the internet and be watching that like crazy. We weren't having greats, not greats, I'm gonna call them, but like people that originally come from the culture have come to this country and gone and traveled now and taught these workshops and stuff, and they're not as hard to get a hold of anymore, kind of thing. Back in the day, it was really hard, so try, go at it as if it's scarce and still really hard. Go and find all these old Litefeet battles to then come into the new ones and see what's going on now, kind of thing. Let's do this. I'll talk forever. Let's talk forever. Here we are.
Hey, Christmas, Jeff.
It's my style.
It's not actually back.
Yes, 6 minutes.
6 minutes, but more than enough time. Cool. Last one's a fakie. Fakie is like what we did with the journal clap. Where we're going to hit that beat, but we didn't. We fake it and carry it on. So when we do this, ha! That's gonna be a fakie. What you're gonna do is go ha! And just wave out both your arms. Go! It's like you continued it on. Wave out. Then we're gonna tic-tac-toe, elbows to knees. You're gonna go tap, tap, up, tap, tap. Then you're gonna lock in. Boom. And then that's like, you're, oh, I'm gonna do it. No, I'm gonna do it. Boom. And then that's what gets people, their energy levels going.
Alrighty. Alrighty, mate. With the music. So just a little recap, quickly before it ends. And five, six, seven, eight. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, and five, six, seven, and eight. Remember, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and research, go watch, because this stuff is only trending past 2 years, trending around the world, probably past 2 years, past year. This started in 2003, like they've been battling since then. Too real, boom.
Yes. Your life, alright.
What's good, people? I'm telling you now. So,
tell us about yourself, Shin.
Shin, aka Shintastic. I've been doing Litefeet for about 3 years now, 4 years. It was like a couple months before the first Litefest. I've been doing Litefeet. Like I said before, when I first started, it was only like a handful of us that was actually doing it at the time, kind of thing. When I first found it, like, I've already been dancing for like 10 years now or whatever, and I usually do all styles, but I'm aiming hip hop.
I always kind of competed and battled in hip hop. Now, I don't know who dances or battles in hip hop here, but with hip hop freestyle, it's not the same energy as Litefeet, where you won't see a hip hop freestyle battle that go straight, ham for it, kind of like that. So when I found Litefeet, it felt like it matched my energy, and that's what kept me stuck into it. I got addicted to it, kind of thing. Started doing my research and watching videos, because at the time it was only myself that I knew that was doing Litefeet. I heard that Yuji, he knew a bit of Litefeet, and we haven't proper spoken about it at that time. At this point, Derek couldn't even dance. Yeah.
Yes, I like Derek.
Derek couldn't even dance at this point. That old Litefeet, he was bad. He was bad. I just want to let you guys know, so you got some motivation there. But those times there, linked up with Yuji, and then he's the one that kind of like got me down with 2Real, because he was already down with 2Real from Blackside. And then I met Jay Black, who's like a legend, CEO of 2Real, and then he officially put me down with it, kind of thing. And but since then, I've just been 2Real to the death, really. That's my Litefeet crew, 2Real boys. They're one of the, it's like second generation Litefeet crew in New York, where they used to do their battles and stuff before or after, like Brotherhood and other crews that are still about that were like the first Litefeet crews. But they're going strong and they're going good. And that's basically what I do in terms of Litefeet. And also I made music. So like some of the tracks that you would have heard in the class, I would have made as well. And then that's what else kind of got my name around the scene. Because I made one Litefeet song, produced one Litefeet song, put it out there, and the whole world started dancing to it and doing Litefeet to it. So I was gas kind of thing. So if you want to find me, SoundCloud, Spotify, it's Shintastic. Just Google Shintastic, you'll find me kind of thing. But yeah, that's about me. I love dance. Dance is what I do. Music's my second passion. And Litefeet's amazing. Pretty much. Is there anything like, do you want me to tell you about Litefeet in general?
Yeah, like I think you mentioned like some step, like I don't want to say they're gonna mention all of them, but like remember you mentioned that like, the rev up, usually when you start your set, right? Rev up, tick tock, lock in, which is like kind of your punctuation, right?
I was really like just throwing a lot of content at you guys, so if you didn't soak it all in, there's no problem with that. Like, you can rewatch the video, but like I said, go do your research, yeah? Find and watch as many Litefeet battles as you can, because this thing here, it's not just a dance, it's not just a dance style, this is a whole culture. So when I tell you about a culture, it means people don't just, it's not just us all dancing similar and have a way of dancing with each other. We walk a certain way, we talk a certain way. This is why I say we use the word spanky, we use the word stupid. It's a culture. Like, there's guys that have lived and died for this, yeah? Still, to this day. Like, the other day, we lost the legend in a Litefeet game. That's passed, you know what I mean? So, it's them ones there. The way that the world is turning with social media and TikTok, all the new dances don't really get their respects, what they deserve, and it turns into a trend. So really, do your research, put love into Litefeet if you're enjoying it, and let's not make it a trend. Let's start creating and adding and giving more to Litefeet, as well as doing our research and learning and understanding it kind of thing. You get me?
Okay.
Yeah? And also, this, no matter how good my skills get, no matter how sick I am, and I am quite sick, yeah? And my knowledge of just the Litefeet music, because I make the music, this will always be a watered down version. I am not from New York. Yeah, I am not from Harlem where this is like made and created. You know what I mean? There's something you can learn from over there, whether you want to travel over there or you want to get in contact with people from over there that are doing Litefeet or legends that are already around there. It's always best to go to the source. I shouldn't have to tell you that. Yeah?
Okay. Hey, also, you teach, right? Where do you teach?
At the moment, I just teach randomly for like different schools and stuff like that. You'll find me teaching online sometimes, just on my own platform. So that's just Official Shin on Instagram. And then I'll probably put all the details on there. But other than that, in Birmingham soon, I've got a studio opening up, Big Dream Studio. That's going to be my dad's studio, and that's where you'll find me.
Okay. A studio base as well, right?
Base as well. I'll be doing my first my first pop-up class of the year will be in January, towards the end of January, so keep an eye out for that date at base.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.